In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Worksheet, Line Segments, and Measure. So our directions are to use a ruler to measure the length of each segment, measure each segment in inches, and then we're going to round our measurements to the nearest eighth of an inch. I have a tutorial that goes over how to use a ruler, so these practice problems go directly along with that. So let's look at number one. We want to line our ruler up on the edge of the line, count over using the inches side, 1, 2, 3. So we're exactly at 3 inches. So for number one, our answer is 3 inches. And you can either write 3, and then the two tick marks, which represent inches, or you can write 3 IN for inches. Either is correct. Next, looking at number two, you can see that it falls, if we're counting by quarter of an inches, 1/4 inch, 2/4 inch, 3/4 inch. So number two is 3/4 inch. And number three, lining our ruler up with the end of the line, you can see that we're going past an inch, and we're going past it by the smallest tick marks are 1/16 inch. However, we're measuring to the nearest eighth of an inch, so let's count over eighths. So this is 1/8, 2/8. So we have 1 inch and 2/8 inch, which 2/8 is really 1/4. So this is 1 1/4, or 1/4 inch. Moving on to number four, lining our ruler up with the edge. Here's 1 inch, and then we're going over 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8. And 5/8 cannot be simplified, so it's 1 5/8 inch. Next, let's move on to number five. Lining the ruler up with the edge, you can see here's 1 inch, here is 2 inch, but it doesn't go all the way to 3 inches, so we're going to start counting our tick marks. So starting at the 2, here's 1/8, 2/8, 3/8. So number 5 is approximately 2 3/8, because it is closest to 3/8, not the 2/8 mark. So 2 3/8 for number 5. Number 6, you can see that it lands right on the 2-inch mark. So number 6 is 2 inches. Number 7, lining our ruler up with the edge of the line. It falls between the 2 and the 3. We know that we're 2 inches and something else. 8/8 would be here, so if we go back 1/8, that would get us to 7/8. So this is approximately 2 7/8 inches. And number 8, lining our ruler up with the edge, we do not even make it to the 1 inch. So we know that this is less than an inch, so it's a fraction of an inch. Here's 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8. So this is approximately 5/8 inch. I'm going to have to zoom out for the following lines so that you can see them in the entire frame. Lining our ruler up with 9. Going across, you can see here is 5 inches, so the end of the line falls between 5 and 6. So it's going to be 5 inches and some fraction. And this fraction happens to be 3/4. So this is 5 3/4 inch. If you were counting by eighths, 3/4 inch would have been 6/8, which simplifies to 3/4. So you always want to simplify your fractions. Number 10, we're a little bit over 6 inches. We're approximately 1/8 past 6 inches. So this is 6 1/8 inch. Number 11, lining our ruler up, you can see that it falls halfway between 5 4. So this is 4 1/2 inches. And number 12, lining my ruler up on the edge, I'm going to have to scoot this over so you can see that it falls right at 7 inches. Here's my 6-inch mark. Here's my 7-inch mark. So the length of the line in number 12 is 7 inches. Number 13, lining our ruler up, we go right past 4 inches and we go approximately 1/8 past 4 inches. So remember, I'm not counting the smallest tick marks because this ruler is broken up into 1/16 of an inch. I'm counting the second smallest tick marks, which are my 1/8. So I get 4 1/8 of an inch. And the last problem I'll do in this video is number 14. On number 14, I'm going to line my ruler right below the line, but lined up with the edge. And you can see that it falls between 3 and 4 inches, and it's 3/4 of the way, or 6/8. So this is going to be 3 3/4 of an inch. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Also, if you're confused about how to use a ruler, specifically the side with the inches, go to my tutorial within my geometry section where I go more in depth with the fractions that an inch is broken up into.